Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shiny castle.
Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind.
But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away.
But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within.
And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress.
The prince tried to recall them, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart.
As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there.
If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time.
As years passed, he fell into despair, lost all hope.
For who could ever learn to love a beast?
It's my favorite part.
I know.
No beast or wand has a chance against you, and no girl for that matter.
It's true, Lafou, and I've got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
She's the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's...
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know, but...
and don't I deserve the best?
Well, of course you do.
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. For in town there's only she who's as beautiful as me, so I'm making plans to ruin Mary Bell.
Be careful. He must have lost his way in the woods.
Maybe if we keep quiet, he'll go away.
I don't mean to intrude, but I'm lost. I need a place to stay for the night.
Poor fellow. Oh, Cogsworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
Egad.
And goodbye.
Wait. You're a clock. You're talking.
Really, sir? Stop it, I say!
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be rude. It's that I've never seen.
You're chilled to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
So, babies. I'm only getting married. Don't tell me a little thing like that is going to change your feelings about me.
Oh, no.
Good. Well, if I'm going to get married, I may as well propose to the bride.
Gaston! What a pleasant surprise.
Isn't it, though? I'm just full of surprises. Can I see those? For you, mademoiselle.
Oh, Gaston, you shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. Belle, this is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Plenty. Picture this. A rustic hunting lodge right outside the village. My little wife massaging my feet while the strapping boys play on the floor with the dogs. We'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, boys.
Imagine that.
So, Mel, what'll it be?
I just don't deserve you.
Who does?
But thanks for asking.
So how'd it go?
You know that Belle, always playing hard to get.
She turned you down.
For now, but I'll have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Me, the wife of that brainless, boorish... I
finders keepers.
Well, Papa!
If you think that what you pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche.
Wait, this is impossible. That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Oh, well, of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry, this is all just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
I'm going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through. Hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make them both to live in heaven well, it's
she thinks she is. That girl is tangled with the wrong man.
Darn right.
No one says no to Gaston. Dismissed. Rejected. Publicly humiliated. It's more than I can bear.
Bear? Where?
Oh, the food. I'm disgraced.
Who, you? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston. Looking so down in the dark. Every guy here loved to be you, Gaston. Even when taking your lumps, there's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy.
I'm especially good at expectorating.
Right.
Help! Help! Someone help me!
Maurice!
He's got her! He's got her locked in a dungeon!
Who?
Belle! We must go at once! Not a minute to lose!
Whoa! Slow down, Maurice. Who's got Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast! A horrible, monstrous beast! All right then, I'll go back there and get her out myself.
You go and pick her up.
Crazy old Maurice. Crazy old Maurice. The fool, I'm afraid I've been thinking.
A dangerous pastime?
I know. But that wacky old coot is Belle's father, and his sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that loony old man. See, I promised myself I'd be married to Belle, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes?
And we...
No, would she...
Yes!
No, I get it!
Let's go! Time for dinner. Where is she?
I'll go check on her. Won't be a minute.
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm no fool.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell will be broken. We'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful and I'm, well, look at me.
Master, you must help her to see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself more presentable.
Impress her with the rapier.
But be gentle.
But be sincere.
And
above all.
What?
You must control your temper.
Well, where is she?
She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, your eminence, your grace, let's not be hasty.
It's time for dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I'm the master's castle. And I'm telling you to come to dinner.
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affection. Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
Deep breaths, Master. Deep breaths.
Fine. I'll give her one last chance. Belle, would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No, thank you.
Fine! Then stop!
Master, please.
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all.
What were we thinking? We will never be human again.
Well, what would you have us do? Give up? I like this girl. I like her spunk.
If you ask me, she was just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I think that may be the first time I've ever heard him use that word. Hello, dearie.
frighten you too much. He can be a little temperamental.
A little?
I am Cogsworth, head of the household, and this is Lumiere.
Enchanté, mademoiselle.
And if there is anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, anything at all.
Well, I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth.
You heard what the master said.
Oh, pish posh. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread, and then...
Cogsworth, she is not our prisoner. She's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right. Dinner. But if the master finds out,
it'll be our next.
Of course, but what is dinner without a little music? Music!
Ma chérie, mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure to set you up new tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly descends.
Your dinner. Our guest, put our service to the test. Tie a napkin round your neck, chérie, and we'll provide the rest. Soup du jour, hors d'oeuvre, why, we only live to serve. Try the crust up. Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can't sing, they can't dance. After all this is France, and the dinner here is never taken down. Hold your menu, take a glance, and then we'll be our guest.
castle.
Well, actually, I do. Right this way.
Okay, I can do this. Acting a gentleman. Acting a gentleman. This will be good.
Now that is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it ain't Baroque, don't fix it.
May I draw your attention to the flying buttress above the aviary?
Oh, Lumiere, it's also beautiful. I had no idea. If only he were here.
Act like a gentleman. I'm nothing but a fool!
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. Now, up here we have...
What's over there?
Nothing! Nothing at all of any interest in the West Wing!
So that's the West Wing.
That's going.
I wonder what he's hiding in there.
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else! Over here, we have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back!
Don't touch that!
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I
told you to never come here!
I know, but...
You realize what you could have done? Get out!
Out, don't touch me!
No, I...
Promise or no promise, I won't stay in this castle!
I'm sorry. I don't mean to frighten you. You're so little left of me. So little left.
Thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
Well, that's more like it. I knew they could get along if they tried.
So, the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon either. The rose is losing petals at an alarming rate.
And I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give them a little push.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up a bit with a nice bowl of soup?
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure, I wonder why I didn't see him there before.
I'll tell you when you're older. They're still in there?
Yes, and so far he's been a perfect gentleman.
It's hope, son. I've been feeling it too.
I'll be my little friend. The day we went for maybe a plan.
If only that were true, Lumiere.
Ah, human again.
Human again.
Yes, think what that means.
I'll be cooking again, be good looking again, with a mademoiselle out of town. When I'm human again, only human again, poised and polished and beaming with charm, I'll be courting again, she gets sporting again.
It should cause several husbands alarm.
And tweet sweet be myself.
When we're human again, only human again, when we're knickknacks and whatnots no more. I share you, we'd all be top dry. Our lips are and I won't be so human dry. Easily fit through that door.
I can tell you
now, compare is my birth to be human again.
When I'm human again, only human again, when the world once more starts making sense, I'll unwind for a change.
Really? That'll be strange.
Can I help with it? I'm in a tent. In a shack by the sea, I'll sit back, sipping tea. Let my early retirement commence. Far from fools made of wax, I'll get down to brass tacks and relax.
When I'm human again.
What a beautiful story.
I knew you'd like it. I'd like to ask you for something.
What's that?
A second chance. Would you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? You? Effie? Oh, yes! Thank you.
the night to confess your love.
I don't think I can do that.
You must.
How will I know when the moment is right?
You will know because you will hear it here, and you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from the... I can't.
You must. What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
Master, look at the robes. There's so little time left.
I really don't think I can do this.
You can do this, Master. I know you can.
You what?
She has to love him in return.
And now it's too late.
Show me the beast!
your children. Come after them in the night. Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Thank you.
Maybe it's better this way.
No. We're together now. You'll see.
At least I got to see one last.
My dear, of course.
One thing forever. time, Kate and Monica.
Yes, High School Bird!
Literally could not do this without me. I think Kate saw me in a meltdown moment yesterday, and she was like, I'll help you. And I was like, I didn't think you could do it. It's hard, but she did it. It was awesome. Kendall, take a sit. Kendall, she did the human. Our guest side. She designed the dance to be our guest. Came down from high school. came down from high school. We have Graf doing an animal floor here who gave us plenty of help. Set up all these microphones. Again, we put a bit MEF. We have folks up here who have the mics that we got last year and just bring all the different. But I can't understand. I took emotion when I think of all the hard work they did. It's so awesome to see all of you here to enjoy everything they did. They put so much work into this. They've given up so much of their other extracurriculars to stay late. And one final thing, it doesn't all happen if we don't have the support from the families who sit in those car lines waiting for us to release them. We can't thank you enough for the snacks you brought in, for the volunteering, for the help up front, out back. It's all really is a community effort. So give them one final applause.